Well, it's great when you're off for like 8 months on parental leave and you come back and you're playing with snakes. I'm a big fan of that. I'm a little leery, you know. I think it's great, though, you know, having reptiles as birthday party props. I guess it could. And that's what you do, right? We have Mark and Karen here from Edmonton Reptile Parties to show us a little bit about these snakes. What camera am I on? Am I here or here? Okay, I'm over here. I can't see. Tell us a little bit, why bring reptiles into the mix for birthday parties and other parties?
Reason for it is we want to educate people on how to look after these kind of animals and let them know exactly what kind of commitment that they're getting into. And so we educate them a little bit on how these animals are in the wild and then what it's like to look after them as a pet.
So we have some beautiful children here today. This is Aaron, this is Emily. Stella, raise your hand. And Amelia, what are you holding, Stella?
A gecko.
Oh, sorry, here, you need the microphone. You're holding a?
Gecko.
A gecko. And are you having fun with the gecko?
Yep.
Okay, and Aaron, are you cool with this thing?
Yep.
That I'm? Have you, oh, wait a minute, somebody tells me that you've had one of these parties before, is that right?
Yep.
And what was it like?
With the bearded dragon and sugar, a leopard gecko and the baby gecko and the strat gecko and that snakey.
And this one here? And was it fun?
Yep. Yes.
Emily, you're cool with this? Like if I wanted to give you this, would you be, you don't have to be. Are you cool with this if I gave you the snake?
Yeah.
Do you want it? Can I give this?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Here. This is the party in action. Okay? I don't think the snake wants to let. Now, the snake is friendly, right?
Yes it is.
Tell us a little bit about how friendly these reptiles are.
They're really friendly as long as you handle them properly and keep them socialized.
Well,
can make really great pets.
Can you make sure that
like
Emily's handling
any cat, dog, or hamster, or anything like that?
If it's dangerous, I don't want her to.
No, it's okay.
Okay. How do you calm the fears of kids?
Just basically, we let them interact with them and let them touch them. They see how they are with us. And we just show them that, you know, like, they're just like any other animal. You treat them with respect and they're going to be the same back to you.
Amelia, you haven't had a chance. Can we give anything to Amelia?
Yep.
Like, is the beard, have you ever touched one of these things before, Amelia?
Yes.
What have you held before? What have you played with before in reptile action?
Bearded dragon.
A bearded dragon. And here's a bearded dragon right here. Is there any places that you shouldn't touch any of these animals? Is this
the crested gecko, you don't want to be handling its tail because it can lose its tail.
And Amelia, don't touch the tail.
Yeah, a lot of snakes don't want to be poked in the face and stuff, so gentle touching around their head is okay, but you don't want to be grabbing their heads.
Okay, so what sort of reactions do you get from children typically?
Most of them are pretty excited and they really seem to enjoy them and they love petting them and they like to hold them and interact. So
and you say there is an educational aspect to this,
yeah,
too, because you learn about the responsibility.
There is a lot of responsibility and we do like to emphasize on the fact that these guys do live a long time, so they are a lifetime commitment for some of them. As an example, the python can live up to 40 years.
Are you okay with this, Emily?
Yeah.
Here, I can
take it.
The longest
one record is 48 years.
Yeah, it's kind of freaky. How big of a birthday party can you do? Can I put this around my neck or am I asking for trouble?
Putting them around your neck isn't the best idea.
It's a constrictor.
It is? You don't, yeah.
So what we do...
Isn't the best idea,
yes.
Isn't the best idea, just in case they were to get nervous. We wouldn't want them wrapping around a child's neck. So we just put them over our shoulders.
No, but my neck.
No.
It's not a good idea simply because then you're going to teach the children that that's okay.
Don't put these things around your neck, children.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I mean, it's different. It's certainly a new twist on the traditional idea of having a party, and if you want to find out more about it, we've got a link to the Edmonton Reptile Parties website on our website. Just click on the news links. Tomorrow, Gymnastics on Wheels, the adventure bus is coming to CTV. I think that's a little something that we've got going on tomorrow. So listen, Amelia, Stella, Emily, Aaron, and Karen and Mark, thank you both very much for coming
in. Thank you so
kindly. And fun with reptiles. Great times. Just wash your hands when you're done, right?
Yes.
Yes.